then you're not going to fire. You two certainly aren't going to fire. Did I just miss? What happened there? Torpedo in the what? That should have hit. Did it hit? No, I don't think it did it? No. Ooh, I don't know. She's doing a heck of a speed though. Yeah, engines haven't been hit, she'd been be doing well over 30 knots. That's a guess. Yeah, don't run into the ship, please. Right. She's a little bit further away. Actually, she's a little bit closer, so. Deflection, I'm going to down another half degree. Because these shots from this, from my pulse, overshot the target quite a lot. Probably not deflected enough. No. Still way, way over. Never mind. So I'm going to bring you in here. She's doing about 36 knots, she'll be about here. So I need to compensate. About there. Oh, she's up again with the anti-aircraft guns. 3, 2, 1. She's moving there, she should be up there for next turn. And again, don't fire. Don't want you hitting my own torpedoes. Slightly more of a turn. Oh, never mind. I don't want is that torpedo overshooting and then hitting one of these destroyers. Oh! There we go. I bet she's damaged now, but. Hard to tell. I'm gonna bring you around. I think the same. A half, no, another full degree, I think, down elevation. Again, still overshot. I don't believe it. Pumps and AAA. But not our engines. So she's continuing to turn. Bring this. Three, two, one. Whoa, what was that? Was that flak? Sounded like flak. Over my left ear. So she's turning, turning, running. Don't want my torpedo hitting against, I'm not going to let any of the ships fire. I don't know if that's actually even a possibility, but I'm not going to take the chance. Well, I think it is a possibility. I should think. Let's see what happens with this torpedo. No, I might just be... Oh, no, midship. Boom. The torpedo. Oh, no. Disaster. Never mind. Nothing you can do about it. Right, more deflection. No, it's less elevation. Another degree down. Fire. And still too high. Suddenly pumps and AAA that have been hit though, at least damaged here. Nothing further on this, no. Damn. That was a tough little ship. That's two torpedoes and an indirect high explosive shell. Not bad. I think she's still turning. So. That was just almost perfectly mid range, that. So we'll try the same again. Three, two, one. Torpedo where? Don't go over it! You get shot down! I don't know if that's actually going to be enough to hit. Might just clip the aft section of the ship, which won't be a bad thing. Still damage the propulsion. No, it's okay. It's not exactly perfectly in line, but... That'll do. So the wind is almost... Is that about... 22.5 between 45 and 0. So it's about just over about 20 degrees. Again, we're gonna let them all skip. Make them all skip their firing turns. Oh, that's sinking. Oh, it's gonna sink now. There we go. Sorry, mate. But, better than me. Wasn't bad. Codrington Antelope. No damage on that, so it's obviously been repaired for the... I don't know if it actually been repaired, but... Pulse Courageous Exeter. None of these have scored a flipping... I had to reply an aircraft again, but that's the thing with... That's an issue with small, fast ships like destroyers. Capital ships are there to engage other capital ships. So, the third week of November. 1939. We had a U-boat badly damaged in the channel just there. Just check. Codrington must have been repaired. Obviously, just light damage can be repaired while still at sea. But where was the others? They were about here. Wouldn't mind these engaging them. Oh, two battleships and a battlecruiser with a twin destroyer escort. They could have been heading back or they could have been just coming out. But they was down here definitely. So I'm going to move these ships to there. Nope, obviously not. I've lost 212,000 tons. Good grief. What's the weather like? Move to there. Western approaches. That's where those. That's where it said those ships were, but there was actually down here. It's weird. Herming SC. I'm gonna get them. Send them back to Western approaches. We're not messing around. We're not hunting ghosts. To bring you. Well, I've got more in now, haven't I? So I can actually spend. Do I have any to actually spend? Probably don't. No, I've got 3,120. No, that's not really enough. Never mind. I mean, I need to just try to save some up. Be a good idea to try and save some renown. So I can get something a bit bigger. A bit more capable. Now, do I send this fleet into the Mediterranean? There's my merchants. Merchants are still strong there, and also obviously Western approaches, so. But there's nothing guarding up here. The Faroe Island gap. See, all the time they're here, they're catching ships coming out of here, and they can catch them coming out of there as well. But none of them can catch anyone up here, so what I might do is... A second. I want these up here, or here. But then, Dunker's going to... I've selected all them. That's not... Oh, they just moved. What am I thinking? Oh, they moved those. Okay, move those to there. Not going to be enough though, is it? First half week of December. And still no contact. Come on. So I don't know if the light cruiser can actually cover the capital ships the same as destroyers can. They should be able to, but you know, you just don't know the way the game mechanics work. How they're limited. I'd rather not leave the courageous unguarded anyway, full stop. So that's the moot point. I'm not going to even think about leaving there by yourself. Get back up to here. They should be able to cover. Still dark blue, so there should be quite a lot of merchant shipping going through here. Come on. I'll leave them where they are for now. So they're covering that gap. Of course, the German ships could go over there, but they still have to come past through here. I believe, no, they don't. They can go through there. I don't have enough ships to cover this gap. All merchants attacked by submarines. 30,060 tons of merchant shipping sunk. Crikey. Where? North American South Seaboard. God grief. Oh, by the time they get there, they're not going to be effective at all, are they? Crikey. How did they manage to get ships out there? You've only got destroyers to cover that, but we're taking a big of risk. Just two destroyers. I've got two battleships and a battlecruiser. This. They don't respond well to being torpedoed. Although it will probably take quite a few torpedoes to sink one of them. Yeah, so where are they? But the thing is, there is no merchant fleets down here. So how can I lose merchants here? No. Doesn't look like it anyway. I need to cover more areas, but unfortunately I don't have the ships. So I'm going to leave them here. Problem is, I'm not covering my merchants while I'm doing this. I'm not covering this area, it doesn't seem to work. I'll leave them where they are for now. Oh dear, I've only got two destroyers. So I've got U-30, U-30. Tech it, oh it's evening as well, oh, good grief. So I could be losing a capital ship here. That'll be extraordinarily bad. Where's my carrier? Oh, good grief. Right, where are we? You are joking. It's right here. It's heading along. It's heading with us. Right, everyone just go on to flank. Let the destroyers deal with it and the aircraft. Everything on flank. No point trying to shoot at it because you're not going to hit a submarine. Right, we'll try and do a torpedo attack. Up to flank. Just move, just go. Go, go, go. There's nothing you lot can do against a submarine. Unless it surfaces, then it's dead meat, but... Unless you just put the... What am I thinking of? I can use the fleet command. Okay, so the destroyer's got a bearing of 168.1. Let's give him something else to shoot at. So I've got periscope depth. Don't think I can do anything with torpedoes. So being as a midship, but don't think. No. Don't think I can actually aim for that target. Well, I could. But. According to the actual map track, it's moving in exactly the same direction as the rest of my ships. So if I fire two torpedoes, one at that side, one at that side, it should hopefully make it panic. I don't know. 124. So I go for 0.4, 124.0. So if I fire one there. They want 4 degrees below. 123.5. There we go. That's a periscope in the water. See that? And I'm not going to fire a torpedo because it's going to hit this ship, so... Depth charges are more effective than anything, but... Nope. There she is, there's a torpedo. Right. No, we can't do that because I've got the destroyers, haven't I? I want those to be separately controlled. There's no point firing anything. Just keep them all at flank speed. Right, let's keep going. There's no firing, there's no point. Definitely a periscope in the water though there. See that. Periscope depth, but there's no periscope sticking up. Right there. Yeah, I see a lot of tracks. She's not quite heading forward, she's heading slightly off. Slightly off angle to my ship, so I'll 133. I'll make a full degree. A single torpedo, and I'm gonna sell it, then I'm gonna fire anymore. Be a waste. Just want to try and deflect her away. I'm trying to spin you around. I'm trying to bring you around. Well, I think the U-boat's concentrating on this destroyer. The Covington's gonna sneak around. Very sneaky. Yeah, there's definitely a periscope in the water there. Well, I've no idea what just happened. I know what will happen if I lose one of these ships. I'll get sacked. Now, do I have any way of... Do I have any way of getting a torpedo on that? No. It's about here. That's about... That's tall. Pretty much guesswork. Oh, what's that? What is that? I don't know. That's a torpedo. So if I go for the torpedo... I don't want to hit my own ship, obviously. Can I actually... No, I can't really deflect it, can I? No. No, never mind. Might as well recover them. It's going to be no use at all. See any torpedoes of theirs. Not much I can actually do. Let's try and tempt her in. Well, you concentrate on the antelope. I'm concentrate on you. He's in the Coddington. Somehow I keep firing, the angle doesn't seem to represent, as in the torpedo's course, doesn't seem to represent this red line. I mean, that torpedo went that way instead of this way. It's a bit weird. If that's got something to do with it, that should really only control salvos. It's 113.1, so we're 114.1. We should be able to compensate for. Oh, here we go. Periscope depth. Boom. That hit. That torpedo hit. You saw it move into it and hit. But it didn't explode. That's when it's a dud. I didn't get any report for that about it being a dud. Good grief. What a bit good are these torpedoes? To prepare another one? How about a bomb? Fighter with a bomb. Yeah, go on then. Oh, look at them, they're alright, aren't they? Shouldn't look at anything. I'd love to know how on earth a U-boat can keep up with a 24 to 30 knot flotilla. Especially submerged. Sonar contact. Ah. So what can we do now? Probably bugger all. Yeah, don't like that. My elevation is 7.9 degrees. 4.913. Use high explosive shells. So we don't really need to compensate for wind. Well, we do, I suppose. Slightly. If it's anywhere near, it should explode. So 7.9 degrees. 6, 7. So I'll make it about 8 degrees. Fire! Elevation Okay. What I really want to do is get a destroyer over the top, but it'll have to be from its flanks or from, well, aft. If you put it from the aft, it's still gonna, like, it's allowed to sort of attract torpedoes being launched at you. Bow, absolutely not, because it'll just sink your destroyer. So it's 11 degrees. I'm hoping for, is the same thing happened with the destroyer in the last battle, just crack its hull if the shells are close enough. So I'm using staggered shell. Slight compensation. And fire. Oh, torpedo hit. It's like a, is that a type 7? Looks like it. So the torpedo did hit. I think it was torpedo number 4. Yeah, if I had a speed of 2 first of all, then 2 lots of single torpedoes. It's only 800 though, but at least that's one more submarine out of action. Can I mention it's out of my wash? It's 5 miles. Flipping out. Brazil? Yeah, that's what they're doing. They're going around there. But the thing is, I've got no merchant ships down there. So that's what they've done. They've gone down that coastline. They're going to hop across. I'm going to come down to here and try and intercept them. Central Atlantic. Yeah, there we go. So they are trying. Let's get away. You're not going to get away. I'm not kidding, Constable. What I'll do, instead of going to there, I'm going to hop up to here. Because then I'm about to come back. Unless, of course, he intercept me coming back here, but oh, here we go. Oh, no, 2. They're not surface warships, though. Oh, no. Right. No, it's you. No, it's you lot again. I see. Do exactly the same thing with this fleet. Move them to there. Unless they're intercepted by the Marauder fleet heading back. Or Raider fleet, sorry. So that's 2 more U-boats. U-35 and U-36. Need taking out. Good grief, what are you doing? My god! Where are those torpedoes? It's not very sporting, is it? Just angle to 0. The other thing, it's weird that, because they are at 0, so what's going on there? Right, fleet action. To flank speed. That's all I can do for now. I do not want to lose one of these battleships. So one of the U-boats is over here. And the other is over there. Just to get the angle right. Is in the water. Oh my god, I've gone right into them. Right, turn back. Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm losing a battleship. You dirty, 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 dirties. Oh my god, which one's this? That's Warspite. Oh my god, are you gonna get hit by those torpedoes? Well, you're not. You're alright. Should be able to just angle you slightly out the way of this torpedo. Angle it out the way of the torpedo? Never mind. I know what I mean. They've only got a limited amount of range, so I need to. No, not firing at it, you daft bugger. What on earth are you doing? Torpedo from a battleship. We're mad. Try and thread the needle here. Take more than just one torpedo to sink Warspite though.